1994, Yamaha YZ250 two-stroke. Got a big work order on this one. Complete re-scheme. Replica. We spent a long time dialing it in. Wizard on the bench, on and off the bench, getting the jetting correct. Another retro two-stroke. This one's got some extra goodies that Senior will go over.
What's up, guys? You know, I don't know if I should just bow and walk away and let the bike speak for itself or tell you about it. It's that cool of a bike. Long history of winning multiple AMA National Supercross and Motocross Championships. Matter of fact, this bike right here won the 1994 AMA Outdoor National Championship. In fact, in 1994, John Dowd, local pro rider, who I'm wearing his jersey. Check out this jersey, guys. This is an actual Dowd, John Dowd jersey. I thought it was appropriate to wear that while going over this bike with you because he won his first AMA 250 Outdoor National Moto on this bike at Millville. Mike Craig, the factory rider, got injured. John was a Boyson support team rider, so he was the next up in line, and they gave him the factory bike. So John Dowd was fourth in the points. Bradshaw had quit. Mike Craig was injured. And the Yamaha factory team looked at John and said, hey, this guy's kicking ass, local guy from Southwick, Mass. I grew up riding and racing with John at the NASC races, local expert. He had turned pro. And in 94, they gave him a shot, fourth in points, stepped up to the factory bike because the factory rider was injured. He went out whole shot and led for half the moto. Finally was passed by Larocco, but the crowd went nuts, you know, local rider, first time on a factory bike. Second moto, goes out and wins 2-1 for his first overall. Quite a story. And then he got the factory ride for 3 years after that with Yamaha. So this particular bike, again, Reed won the 2004 AMA Supercross Championship on this bike, 5 AMA National Championships, 9 Supercross titles on these Yamaha YZ250s, and 6 off-road titles have been won by various riders over the years. Fantastic, lightweight. Yamahas are renowned for being bulletproof engines running forever. And all of my championships, personally, all 16 of my NESC, NEMX, and NESX local pro and vet championships were on Yamaha. They're bulletproof. Back to this bike here. This is the last of the Uncle Dale collection. If you remember, Uncle Dale donated the Triumph 750 to the museum. This is the last one, folks. Dale was a millionaire trucking company owner. He had 400 trucks at one point. And about a year ago, had a change of life experience. Sold everything, including his collection of 300 bikes. Downsized to just a toy hauler and two bikes. So this is the last one we got in from him. Dale had rebuilt the motor. It is a perfect 215 PSI compression. It's got a brand new FMF Gold Series pipe on it with the PowerCore 2 silencer. It's bristling with trickery from front to back. Looking at the carb bowl, you'll see there's something special about the carb. You might want to take a close look at that. And I've got a long list of parts. This was a frame-off restoration / resto mod. When I say resto mod, it was modified from the original colors to be the 1995 factory race team colors. This is a replica of the 95 Yamaha factory race team. So right down to the frame, every nut and bolt on the bike was taken apart. The frame was sanded and repainted. The swing arm was repainted. The engine, again, Dale had previously rebuilt the motor, so the engine was just recommissioned cosmetically because everything was already rebuilt in it. The clutch is perfect, tranny's perfect, and this thing hauls the mail. Got a long list of parts I'll go over with you, but before I do that, let's look at the obvious stuff. Renthal bars, brand new pair of gorgeous Renthal, almost like a electric blue. I love that color. Brand new set of two-tone Pro Grip 801s. It matches the Renthal crossbar pad beautifully. Brand new Renthal crossbar pad. New levers. Complete new plastic kit, front number plate, new front fender, new white radiator shrouds, new fork protectors, new side covers, new rear fender, brand new Yamaha YZR seat cover, factory replica. Starting at the front, These Hoosier tires, yeah, they cost a bit. It costs us $100 more per set than the Dunlops, but they're worth it. They look awesome. They work awesome. And why didn't I take this in the dirt? Well, the guys, I've got a work order here totaling over 50 hours work. I just didn't have the heart to take this thing out and get it dirty and bring it back in. So, and I didn't want to burn off the new Hoosier tires. So the tires are brand new. They've been up and down the driveway three times. I just rode it up and down the driveway. Other than that, they're brand spanking new, as are the tubes and the rim strips. The chains and sprockets are new. It's got a new gold chain on it. It's got a new shifter on it. Just a stunning machine. The original pegs were replaced with a nice, they look like they're titanium. I'm not sure what they are, but beautiful set of pegs. It has a billet aluminum gas cap on it, which is kind of trick. Brand new twin air filter. Let me go down some of the parts list here. Brand new BR-AES spark plug, a new front sprocket, new chain and sprockets, new plug cap, new FMF pipe, fatty, chrome. New gear, and of course, an FMF silencer. New gear lube. The coolant was replaced with Maxima. New front and rear tires, as I mentioned. New 50-tooth rear sprocket. Hoosier's front and rear, of course. 19-inch rim bands. The graphics kit and the seat kit and the grips and the blue tip shifter and the 966 bend blue bars and the factory ride decal backgrounds with the number ones on them, commemorating the 1994 National Championship. Now, this bike's ready to roll back into the museum on display, or if you want to roll it up to the line at the local pro level, I'm pretty sure this could win against the 254 strokes, putting down 48.8 rear wheel horsepower stock with the pipe and the engine work that's been done to this thing. It also has some special trickery done to the carb. It's called the Boysen Power Bowl on the carb. I'm pretty sure this thing will hold its own against the new armor with the right rider on it, but off-road racing, motocross racing, whatever you want to do. Kenny, can you zoom in on the shock? Because there's something that I have to mention about the shock. This is like the ultimate trickery on a motocross. Yamaha, everybody knows Yamaha has the best suspension, Kiaba suspension. They've been the best for a year. Uncle Dale, money was no object with him. This shock was sent out and DLC coated and rebuilt some time ago. I don't know exactly when, but it's absolutely beautiful. And I've DLC coated a shock tube before. That's a $500 mod. So Dale had put a fair amount of money into the bike. We took it over the finish line. It just needed the cosmetic refreshing that we did. The bike, again, was power washed. The motor was taken out, stripped right down to the frame, the subframe, the swing arm was stripped and painted. The engine was vapor blasted. The wheels were vapor blasted. The shock spring was repainted blue. Complete decal kit was installed. New seat cover. All the wheel bearings are greased. The linkage was replaced with one of Dale's other bikes. And greased a total. Kyle had 32 hours in it. Shane put 2 hours in. Billy put 2 hours in it. A total of 36 hours in the detail shop and 14 hours in the service department. That's a total of 50 hours labor. That's what it takes to do this kind of work, folks. And a fat stack of cash and parts. The grand total of the bike on the work order is $6,250. Now you'd ask yourself, why would anybody in their right mind put $6,250 into this machine? Well, one, it was our Uncle Dale's bike. Two, long history of this bike, winning it's a 94 championship bike, and we love vintage two strokes. That's what it's all about. So no, it's not going to be cheap, but it's going to be worth it. It's a kick-ass bike. The reserve will be set substantially under what we invested into the bike, not including the cost from Uncle Dale. So that's about it, man. Kick-ass bike, plenty of power. Wheelies all every gear coming up the hill with my 220-pound 6'2" frame on it. So I'm sure if you're smaller than me, it'll really haul the mail. Junior, is there anything you'd like to add about this bike? I know you won a bunch of races on this bike.
Yeah, definitely got a soft spot for these Yamis. I think that they they're actually still in production, and this is a late steel chassis model, but it resembles a lot of this bike resembles one of the newer ones. They haven't changed much because it's proven. And guys, lots of upgrades. There's a lot of value here. Vintage two-stroke that's set up and ready to run it to the races.
I wanted to point out, I always check the frame rails. There is, in sake of full disclosure, there's a couple dings right here, two dings, and a little flat spot right here. Does not affect the performance at all. It's just a cosmetic issue. And then on the other side, let's check the other side of the frame.
It's not totally bashed in to the point where...
No, it's just a little dent, that's all.
Right.
It doesn't affect the way the bike. This side of the frame rail, a couple little dings in it, nothing major. The engine cases are in excellent condition, as is the The shifter, I mean, the brake lever was polished. The kicker was polished. The radiators appear to be in good condition. Everything else is right there on the bike. So, just a cool classic two-stroke, ready to rip it. So, if you like two-strokes, these steel frame bikes handle amazing. And the power-to-weight ratio is off the hook, and they're a lot of fun. So, if you have any questions about the bike, give us a call, 860-454-7024. If you're watching this YouTube video and you're wondering if it's for sale, go back to our homepage on our YouTube channel, click on About Us, and there's a link to all of our auctions on there. And please, if you haven't subscribed, hit the subscribe button. It helps us grow our YouTube channel.
Actually, no, the first link at the bottom of this video goes to our auction site. You just scroll down. That's it.
There you go. If you have any questions, again, give us a call. Kick-ass bike, ready for a new home. Good luck bidding on her. Buy this thing and wheelie off into the sunset. Summer's coming, and it's the summer of two-strokes. Good luck bidding, and God bless America.